So many people think that you can get a masked monster or a juicy ripped look completely naturally. Just forget it. Work harder than you think you could ever do, and then you can maybe get halfway. Generally, way more people than you think are on steroids, and it's exactly what these teenage newbies are not told. So, today I'm going to talk about the wrong image people new to the fitness industry get of it, and all the false beliefs and illusions it creates for them. I'm going to use Simian Panda as an example in this video, as he gives the false message about what training and fitness is for the average guy. I'm going to further present how he uses his website, Instagram and YouTube to promote logical fallacies people new to training and the fitness industry start believing in. The idea behind this video is basically to educate you that most big names in the fitness industry use money-driven and egocentric methods to sell their products and share information. I'm going to educate you in the biggest misconceptions and lies these names give out to people with limited research and experience with relevant topics. The reason why I use Simian Panda in this video is because he is one of the pinnacles in the fitness industry. He was actually one of the first fitness promoting guys I knew, along names like Lazar Angelov and Ulysses Jr. It was crazy to see those guys on the magazine covers when I started training, just standing as the alphas of the fitness industry, showing what hardcore training really is. However, many of the biggest guys in the fitness industry sell products, come with statements, and promote workouts and products, developing false beliefs for new people. It's sad that these people actually are told myths and lies, not how to train and eat to progress maximally. Information-based content in the fitness industry is truly infrequent and often overlooked. You really have to follow the right guys in the fitness industry to get the information you need. Imagine a 15 years old who has just started lifting. Why can't they just get good information about how to maximally progress for their training goals? In this video, I will expose exactly the impressions and illusions this arbitrary young guy gets out of watching and getting advice from Simian Panda or other money-driven people in the fitness industry. I also want to say that Simian Panda is one of my favorite followings on Instagram and YouTube. He provides great videos, he has an amazing looking physique, and lives a truly healthy lifestyle. He has a very similar life mentality and a very similar lifestyle to me, and has trained for 20 of his 34 years old life. He trains truly hard, eats well, and enjoys exercising more than anybody. He shows his lifestyle, how he trains, and produces high quality videos and pictures every day. However, he uses social media in the wrong way, sending a false message, and markets himself and his products for an egocentric purpose. Rather than giving out specific information about how to build muscle in the most effective way for an individual, he promotes ineffective training, nutrition, and supplementation to get the most money. Before we start off, make sure to subscribe to my channel. I really want to provide my information and give out to myself to a bigger audience. Therefore, you can help me by clicking on the thumbs up button and subscribing to my channel. I also have an Instagram account where I post pictures and videos of training and nutrition information, personal development, and my own training journey. Link is in the description. First, the first lie Simian Panda's social media business give: you can get way longer without PEDs than what you actually can. On Simian Panda's Instagram profile, he claims he has built his physique naturally. In his description, he gives out the statement, infinite natural. By that, he means he has never touched a performance-enhancing drug in his life. The problem I have with that is that a 15 years old newcomer to training and fitness thinks, train and eat right, and I look like Simian Panda. The biggest and the most ripped natural claimers in the fitness industry, along Simian Panda, like for example Mike O'Hearn, Chul Soon, Carton Lott, or Unome Egger, create delusional people. The truth is that most big names in the fitness social media are not natural. We have, for example, the New Jersey Gang, who have got the truth about their steroid use exposed. The problem is actually the illusions all these fake natties create among regular people new to the fitness industry. So many people think that you can get a mass monster or a juicy ripped look completely naturally. Just forget it, work harder than you think you could ever do, and then you can maybe get halfway. Generally, way more people than you think are on steroids, and it's exactly what these teenage newbies are not told. This is not a Simeon Panda natty or not deep dive. I'm not microanalyzing his delt muscle fiber proportions from 2004 to 2005, or searching for gynecomastia in his pictures. I will just provide some basic facts. The body statistics of this guy is 105 kilograms of body weight and 185 centimeters body fat in the 10 zone. This gives an FFMI of over 27. To provide basic information, he is at the same muscular level as Arnold Schwarzenegger and Chris Bumstead. He has an enormous physique, and he will be a prime competitor for a classic physique show, if he had competed, of course. His waist is super narrow, his shoulders are like bowling balls, his traps are ridiculous, and his legs are extremely developed. His best muscle groups are the muscle groups with most androgen receptors, aka what responds best to steroid use, the delts and traps. I don't want to hear the argument that Simeon Panda has passed a drug test and a polygraph test. The problem is that this is actually a peeing test, analyzing the urine of an individual, and the electrolytes from the PEDs disappear after being out of the body system for 2 to 5 days. This means Simeon Panda could pass this test by being off cycle for a few days. Also, the polygraph test doesn't work like a lie detector test, it works like a fear detector test. The testing method only analyzes how a person responds with his physiological signals, like changes in heart rate and blood pressure indicating how nervous he is. This means he could pass the test by literally believing his own lie about steroid use, and there are also video guides on YouTube for passing that kind of a test. Many people always try to say that Simeon Panda has great genetics. This goes of course in his favor, but he has a similar size to all the top end guys in classic physique Mr. Olympia, where all physiques are made out of elite genetics. He is bigger than all the Mr. Americas, the prime genetics and physiques of bodybuilding before steroids were invented. I also know that Simeon stays around the same body weight the year around. This explains that he is not cycling steroids, and means he is either lying about that he has been on cycles in the beginning of his training career, or that he is on a constant dose of HRT, hormone replacement therapy. Basically, Simeon Panda needs to be a genetic mutation like a Belgian blue for being a possible natural athlete. People believing in that people like Simeon Panda are not on PEDs are believing in blatant lies. And even if he actually is the biggest freak of all time, his natural claim creates delusional people believing in that mass monster looks are attainable naturally. It's sad that people new to the fitness industry get misinformation about how muscular they can get with lifting weights. It creates people with way too big expectations, and this only sets them up for unattainable goals and failure. The best sort of information for these people is what they actually could gain in terms of muscle and strength from lifting weights, and what is achievable with and without PEDs. I will also recommend conservatively made and deeply going natty or not videos on YouTube, basically for educating the main characteristics of a steroid user. The second misconception Simeon provides is selling unspecified training programs and nutrition plans that most lifters will not progress from. Simeon Panda sells programs and diet plans on his website for $50 to $60. They can be found in the program section as Mass Gain Extreme and Fat Burn Extreme, and include a 7-day training plan and an eating plan. He markets them for being effective for people aiming to build muscle or lose fat, which also perpetuate the yo-yo mentality of money-driven sales methods. One of the problems with the programs on Simeon's website is that there are no information about who will benefit from these. He markets them for everybody aiming to gain weight or lose fat, which is basically everybody in the gym. There are no specifications if this is men or women, or beginners or intermediates. The training program is very generalized and only trains a muscle group once a week. This means you can find a similarly good training program for free at bodybuilding.com or watch the right information influencers on YouTube. Therefore, the $50 you pay Simeon is a waste of money. Another problem is that the muscle protein synthesis only lasts for 48 hours after a workout, and as you only train once in a week in Simeon's extreme programs, you miss out of the remaining 120 hours of the week. The programs contain huge amounts of volume per session and accessory exercises. This is very fatiguing for beginners and not necessary for other than intermediate and advanced athletes. In addition, his diet guidelines are very standardized and not specialized for the individual, not even specified for a lifter of a certain advancement. The problem is that a young complete beginner will get fat from eating this food, and an advanced and active athlete like me will starve from eating the meals in Simeon's diet plans. Here the principle of specification comes in. You have to be very specific about who will benefit from something and who will not. Dieting is very individualized as people of different sizes, compositions and activity levels are set up for largely different responses for a certain calorie amount. Further, you could get the exact same results from a diet plan from, again, bodybuilding.com, or watch a video for free from the right influencers on how to eat while shredding of fat on YouTube. There's lots of free information about eating right for building muscle or losing fat. Paying $50 for a plan from a famous fitness person is for almost everybody money badly spent. In his promotion of his diet plans, he also gives misleading information about the results of his buyers. For example, he states this guy has gone from 20 to 10% body fat. The problem is that these numbers are given by his scale weight. The truth is that these body fat numbers are wrong, and half of the weight loss is water weight or glycogen. As we know, the body depletes glycogen from being in a state of a calorie deficit. It's exactly what this guy has done. Therefore, the after picture of the transformation is actually more like 15% body fat. In addition, this transformation could be done by use of basic nutrition information, which can be found from following the right information providers on YouTube. You don't need to buy an expensive plan for eating right. Basic nutrition and recovery information is key for anyone. The third immoral business provided by Simeon Panda is selling supplements beginners don't need for high prices. The problem with it is that it creates an illusion about that supplements are more important than what they actually are. I often get the question from beginners, what supplements should I take? Do I need creatine? I also hear way too often, oh, I need this fat burn to shred off fat for the summer. Simeon drifts his supplement company Innoceps and markets his supplements for being lab tested, produced in certified facilities, soy free, gluten free and free of artificial sweeteners. His marketing objectives are promoted to be fat torching and muscle building. His flagship supplements are InnoShred, Advanced Isolate Whey, Max Strength and Natural BCAA. So this is basically a fat burner, a protein powder, a combination of citrulline malate, beta-alanine and a few other supplements, and a variant of BCAA. Actually, the only one of these a beginner needs is probably protein powder. Most beginners could also consider creatine or a pre-workout or any source of caffeine. First, the actual effect from a fat burner is close to useless. It works precisely as a thermic burner, purposely meant to increase the energy expenditure. Some of the main ingredients in the InnoShred is green tea, green coffee, and some fruit and paradise extracts. The problem is that the thermogenic effect from these ingredients is actually theoretical. Basically, you increase your energy expenditure with probably 50 calories. Most people will burn equally many calories from walking for 10 minutes. Therefore, investing money on a fat burner is completely unnecessary. Moreover, the Advanced Isolate Whey has close to zero benefits over regular protein powder sold in regular companies. The only real benefit of this variant of protein powder is that it doesn't contain artificial sweeteners and is slower digested than regular protein powder. However, the overpricing is ridiculous and everybody can buy a product with a close to identical effect from a regular supplement company for way less money. Going over the Max Strength supplement, beta-alanine and citrulline malate are only recommended supplements for intermediate and advanced athletes maximizing their training performance. As most of the buying group is beginners, people get a product they actually don't need. The problem I have with the entire marketing approach from Simeon Panda is that it gives an illusion for people that supplements are crucial for fat loss and muscle building. Diet and training optimization is crucial for these two processes to happen. I can't understand why people just can't explain about proper diet and training rather than promoting ineffective supplements. The fitness industry is way too money-driven, diminishing the informal part, which lots of people could benefit hugely from. It's actually sad that Simian Panda is one of the first names anybody new to the fitness industry get to know. Or to state it precisely, I'm not against anybody that watches and gets inspired from Simian Panda's training, pictures and physique. I think many people, including myself, get huge motivation from watching what he does in his everyday life and how he makes proficient pictures and videos. However, I'm against that he promotes bad values from lying on his steroid use and selling ineffective supplements and training and nutrition plans for money-driven reasons. I'm against his sale approach and information sparse content production. I really wish beginner lifters actually could get more information-based content relevant for their training goals. Not lies and exaggerations about monetized training programs, diet plans and supplements. And if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Also, comment down below, do you think Simian Panda is natural? Have you bought his diet and training plans? Also, make sure to subscribe to my channel. I really want to talk to a bigger audience. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Mixter Physique signing out.